morning. You're watching Amuseaholics, and today we're here at Parque Warner Madrid.
Yeah, another first visit park for us.
Yeah, our first time visiting here. My goodness, the weather's warm here compared to where we've been from, isn't it?
Yes. It's going to be 28 degrees later on today.
Could be as high as 28 degrees, yeah. So it's going to be a very warm, sunny day. This park does have a couple of water rides, Rio Bravo, and there's also some rapids, isn't there?
Yes.
So yeah, we're really looking forward to giving those a go later. Got a few decent coasters here as well. They've got Superman Flawless B&M coaster, Batman Inverted coaster, Stunt Drop, which is like a Vekoma boomerang, I believe, like a inverted boomerang. And yeah, so there's quite a few attractions here to enjoy, a couple of dark rides as well.
Yep.
Really well themed park from what we've seen just walking through the entrance. Lots of really cool buildings, really good Universal sort of vibe, Hollywood Studio sort of vibe. Really, really good. So yeah.
Yeah, I love a good themed park, so we're looking forward to it.
Yeah, that's right, so let's head in and see what we can find.
Yeah, let's go.
So we made it over to the entrance plaza just before the turnstiles. Parque Warner Madrid. Really nice waterfall. Well, say waterfall, fountain in the middle of the plaza here. Really love the big sign up at the entrance. Makes a really grand display. So here we are at the entrance plaza. All the Hollywood type buildings. Really impressive fountain inside to greet us. What a display. Looking quite busy here today. Really nice sunny day. I think there's quite a few school trips here on this Friday. But looking really nice in here so far. Really like the aesthetic of it. All the sort of Hollywood vibes. Really well themed so far. Let's carry on into the park. Really nice oriental themed building there. See part of the new coaster a bit further down the strip. We're going to continue on and make the most of our day. So it's just before 12 o'clock. We headed off to the left towards Superman. You might just about be able to see in the distance. But we're just waiting for the rope drop now at 12 o'clock. Quite a big crowd already gathering. Look at the mayhem with the rope drop. Everybody's running for it. So there's enough rides to go around, eh? They're all a bit eager beavers. Now, I love a good ride, but running in 27 degree heat, probably not the best idea, so we're just going to have a nice stroll over there, taking all the theme in. Got 2 days here at Parque Warner, so there's no need for us to rush. Walking on through towards Superman with the herd. See, you got Jack's Fish Market there. Also see the towers a bit more clearly, another bit of the coaster. See in the distance, they're testing the drop towers. Looks like it goes up slowly. And then stays there for quite a while. Hey, there it goes. See the lift hill for Superman in the distance. Following best practice when you have a busy start to the day and heading towards the back of the park first. Some brilliant theming throughout here though. Really reminds me of Universal Studios, Movie Park, all those. See there the Haunted House. I believe that's a dark ride madhouse attraction. So check that out a little bit later on. So we made it over to the Daily Planet building, entrance to the Superman ride. Not open just yet, so we're just waiting here. Here we are on the entrance to the Daily Planet. Steaming here in the queue line, still the offices. test seat there in case you need to make sure you fit comfortably. And here it is testing. There it goes. A familiar roar of a B&M coaster. We've made it over to the queue line itself now. It's like the queue's coming to a stop, so time to wait for this exciting ride. Here we are on the Superman station. So we just took our very first ride on Superman, B&M Flawless Coaster. Yeah, quite enjoyed it. It wasn't the smoothest B&M coaster I've ever been on. It was quite very rumbly when you drop into the dips. I didn't think the first drop was as forceful as I would have liked either. I mean, it was sort of a straight drop rather than into a turn, and I don't know if that's part of it, but it just felt like there was a lot of force on the first drop.
Yeah, I would agree, yeah. And you did get a little bit of extra air time, but it wasn't as much as I was expecting. It kind of just drifted out your seat a bit and then went back down.
Yeah, there was
that's because we were in the middle or
yeah, we were on row 5, so whether that's because of being on row 5 or just, you know, that's just the way the ride is. There were a couple of hills where we did get a little bit of air time, but not major ejector air time, just like a little bit of float, I would say. Yeah, it's a pretty solid ride. There's some nice elements in there. Yeah, the interlocking corkscrews are nice, the loop-the-loop. The last couple of sort of inversions did sort of throw you a little bit. There's a nice helix at the end. That's got a nice bit of force on it, and that's where the photo is. So be smiling when you drop into the helix, because that's where they take your photo. I didn't realise also this ride has on-ride video, so you can actually buy a video of yourself on the ride. The viewpoint's a little bit on the low side, to be honest with you. And I didn't realise it was on-ride video either, but it was quite good actually. I mean, yeah. It wasn't the best ride I've ever been on, but it was a decent coaster.
I enjoyed it. I was on the end, so it was a little bit rumbly at places. Not uncomfortable, but it did just like rumble me head about a little bit.
Yeah, it does have a little bit of a roughness to it, that one. It's a solid coaster.
Yeah, it's good.
It's good fun, and what better way to enjoy the sunshine than having to shoot through some corkscrews and through some loop-the-loops?
Yeah, definitely got a bit of cool off in the how fast the ride was with the air blowing on us.
It's got that familiar B&M roar, the roar of Superman charging towards his enemies. But yeah, absolutely fantastic. We enjoyed our first ride on there. Certainly not the best ride we've ever been on, but we certainly thought it was a good coaster.
Yeah, so enjoyed it, yeah.
Well, we're just heading over to the Hotel Embrugedo, if I'm saying that correctly. It's a Vekoma Madhouse, I believe, dark ride. Haven't done one of these for a while, so look forward to getting in and giving it a go. Like the entrance hallway. Little scary statue. Looks like there's a bit of a bashing area here. Doesn't look like there's too long of a queue, which is good. So yeah, we're gonna head in now and take a look. The reception for the creepy hotel. With a lounge area over there as well. A little suit of armour. Typical creepy aesthetic.
No me extraña. La biblioteca de un hotel es un lugar solitario.
So we just took a go on the dark ride, the Madhouse.
Yes.
And to be honest, we weren't really impressed. I mean, the aesthetic on the outside, absolutely fantastic. First sort of walkway into the queue line, fantastic. Bashing area, okay, a little bit dark, not a massive amount of detail in there. The first room, I would say, again, was okay.
Yeah, it was alright, it was quite fun.
Moderately detailed. I mean, there's a projection mapping on a couple of sort of stone head statues, which was interesting. Obviously, it was in Spanish, so we didn't really understand. It was quite a good finale to the pre-show, which we quite liked, which we'll keep a surprise for you. But then you go into the Madhouse room itself. And again, the aesthetic in there looked good at first glance.
Yeah.
But obviously, when the restraints came down, they were very tight.
yeah, it's really, really, really hurt my stomach and my leg. Because I was right at the end.
Yeah.
So the restraints caught my side of my leg and my stomach, and it's actually really hurting me.
I had a similar problem because I was in the start of the next section, so it's not...
it's not too excessive.
Not well suited for larger people. Well, we're not that large, really, right? We're medium-sized people. But yeah, it does come down quite a lot of force on that one. I'm not sure why, but yeah. The other thing that disappointed me really is right at the very start, there's a bit of a scene change slightly on the table in front of you. That was really good. But what really disappointed me after that was there was not really anything else revealed, was there?
No, not a lot was going on. And I don't know if it's because we couldn't understand it either. That probably didn't help. So.
Yeah, the fact the show was in Spanish meant we didn't really get what was going on. There's a screen at each end of the show and we could only understood bits of it, and only one of the screens was working. So the one closest to us wasn't working either, which was disappointing. So yeah, a little bit disenchanted by that experience really. It wasn't even cool in there, was it? There's not even any air conditioning in there as far as we could tell. It seems the same temperature as outside. I know this is not ridiculously hot for how hot Spain can get, but obviously we're not being used to it. We were hoping for a bit of a cool off, but it wasn't meant to be. So yeah, a little bit disenchanted by the madhouse, but you know, so at least it's a ride that we didn't have to wait long for. Really like this harbour area. See the water tower again in the distance. And stunt fall. Looks to me like this might be an area where they perform shows sometimes. Maybe not this time of year, not sure. Let's have a look. But yeah, a really nice area to look at. We are approaching the Gotham City area. Quite a lot of games. And the Batman coaster is just over there on the left hand side. Just walking around now trying to locate the entrance. It's like a really big plaza where there's lots of different games here. To win yourself some teddies, some Harlequins there. Here we are approaching Batman, Shadows of Arkham. Entering Arkham Asylum now. Like the spooky aesthetic over here. Quite like the gargoyles that are reaching down there. Joker's left a little message there. Welcome to the Joker Funhouse. I really like this first entry hallway. Get your test seat over on the left if you want to try it out. And the patient processing. Hey, you set the alarm off, can't even know you're here. That's cool. I like that. That's really good. More messages from the Joker, come for fun. This really adds to the experience. All the costumes and props there. But unfortunately none of that's good enough for us. We need to go for the Arkham Asylum intensive treatment. Near the hustle and bustle of people, so I think we're fast approaching the queue now. Yeah, I've really enjoyed this queue line though. I think it's really nicely put together. So we made it up into the Batman station. So you can start with the Arkham Asylum theme. There's the inverted train just loading up now. Gotham City Police vehicle here. Looks like it's a bit worse for wear, probably thanks to the Joker. Pull again, Batman. That's a shame. Batmobile over by the Batman Shadows of Arkham exit.
Well, we just took a ride on Shadows of Arkham, the Batman ride.
Yeah, inverted B&M coaster.
Yeah, good to get another B&M in verse and its nemesis is down at the moment.
Yeah, that's right. And to be fair, the theme in the sort of starting part of the queue line, absolutely brilliant. Like the facade outside of the Batmobile right behind us. And yeah, so the ride was decent, to be honest with you. It's a good layout, two loop the loops, wasn't there?
It's very intense. Yeah. Very intense anyway.
Yeah, we were the last but one row, and yeah, did seem pretty intense. Yeah. Loved the first drop, love how it swings straight into a left bend, straight into the first loop the loop. Then obviously there's a couple of corkscrews in there as well, and just really, really nice layout.
Yeah, and there's a second loop the loop.
Yeah, love that second loop. So I caught us off guard because you can't, you can just about see it. Now we know to look for it. But we saw the first loop approaching the ride, but we never saw the second loop. So that was a nice surprise. We haven't done much on the way of the American circuit, so we know there's a lot of clones of this in America and Six Flags. But we haven't been to one of those parks yet. So, hey, there it goes. So we haven't been to one of those parks yet, so we hadn't experienced this layout before, I don't think. So yeah, that was all good, enjoyed all that. On the negative side, the queue times on the Park Warner app are basically nonsense. We joined the queue with a posted wait time of 10 minutes, and we timed it and we actually waited 55 minutes.
Yeah.
Now, we don't mind waiting an hour for a decent coaster, especially when we've never ridden before. But, you know, when you're expected to wait 10 minutes and then you have to wait 55, it's not good, is it?
Yeah, see, it's difficult too, because obviously we haven't been here before, so we didn't know where the station was, so relative to where it was in the queue. Mm. So if we even expected that time, then, you know, we would have known, but obviously because it's our first time, we didn't know where far the station away was, so...
Yeah, the queue line moved very slowly as well. They're only running one train, so... You know, in terms of operations, it's been a little bit not really up to the standard we've been experiencing so far on this trip, is it?
No, they only was running one train on Superman as well, so...
Yeah, and admittedly, we understand it's a Friday, so technically it's a weekday, but they seem to have quite a few school trips here. It's still very busy, and really, we think when your wait times are over half an hour, you should be putting that second train on, so...
And also, very confusingly, there were people walking past us, and I think they had, like, fast passes, but it's not very clear, like, where they were supposed to be going or... So we haven't done that yet, have we?
No, that's right, but the...
It was a bit confusing.
Like you said, the fast pass entrance, we saw the fast pass entrance, but it was halfway through the regular queue line. Yeah. So the people who had fast passes had to essentially try and mingle their way through the crowd of the normal line to get to where it branches off to fast pass, which again just seems very badly designed.
But then we got to the branch of the fast pass and it was chained off as well, so I'm not sure if they had to walk all the way to the front of our queue or what, because there was a lot of times in the section of the queue that we were standing still, so I think that they were just letting all the fast passes on and then letting us on afterwards.
Yeah, so that might have contributed to the long wait time.
Yeah.
And we understand that fast passes can't really be taken into account when estimating queue times, but let's face it, 10 minutes when it was 55, it's not even close.
No, it's not.
So from that point of view, from the operations point of view, pretty disappointed really. The ride itself, decent inverted coaster.
Yeah, the ride itself was good. I just need to put more trains on.
Yeah, definitely needs that second train on. Definitely needs a second train on both the rides, because as I say, the queues are getting quite long and there's no air conditioner or anything like that. It is quite warm in there as well. So, and to be honest, because the queues are moving so slowly, it kind of is a bit harder on your feet.
Yeah.
So, yeah, I would say they definitely need to take the initiative and put that second train on.
Definitely.
So continue through Gotham. We've got the Joker, Coches de Coca. Basically bumper cars. Bit weird. Sorry for the terrible pronunciation. Take a look at these. I like the theming on the cars, how they're sort of like older style cars. I love the Joker figureheads on bonbons. It's like a sweet shop. Maybe a sweet and gift shop. Got the Gotham City stunt show. No time posted, so I'm guessing that's not going to be on today, which is a bit of a shame. Another great set piece here in the middle. Now if we take a look up, you can see the stall on the brand new Gotham City Escape Coaster. You see a lot of work going on around the Gotham City Escape Coaster. Really like The buildings in the background, Ace Chemical. Another section of track here from the Gotham City Escape coaster. If I just turn to my left here, here it is. The gates to Batman Gotham City Escape. Yes, the Wayne Mansion. Doesn't look very Wayne Mansion if I'm totally honest, but maybe it's from a different, you know, not from the movies, more like the comic book perhaps. But yeah, I do like the central part, which is almost like, you know, the roundabout where you pull up to the driveway. So we're going to carry on through to the Old West territory. Bit of a graveyard over here on the right as we come in. And we do love a Wild West themed area in a park, so looking forward to getting in here and having a look around. And we're continuing through the Old West territory. So really authentic with the heat, to be fair. You can see the Woody in the background there. Coaster Express. And looks like there's a haunted house just there. It looks like it's open, so I'll take a look at that in a bit. That one has a €6 upcharge to enter, so I'm not sure where you get tickets from. We'll have to have a look. I'll just walk forward slightly and then look to the left. You can see the entrance to Rio Bravo there. So we made our way over to the El Coyote Solitario Saloon, if I'm saying that right. Absolutely love the buildings in this park. They really do make it. Here we are in the saloon. So we popped inside the saloon. We've got ourselves a hot dog. €4.50. Not too bad for a theme park. Also got some strawberry smoothies. They look really nice on a hot day like today. And the Parque Warner Madrid cups, and also a Coke. Kelly's got the famous plain hot dog. Look at this, try and let you know what we thought. I guess Coaster Express. And we made it over to the Rio Bravo entrance now. Thought this is a really good water ride, so looking forward to getting on and giving it a go. Really like the Rio Bravo show building here. Really huge set piece. Just like most of the building set pieces here. Really, really big. Really, really grand. Well, didn't take long to get to the Rio Bravo station. Inside this huge building. Boats are launching pretty rapidly. And there's a bit of a cattle pen here, but I don't think the queue's gonna be too long actually. Probably 10-15 minutes. So we just took a ride on Rio Bravo.
Yeah, I'm absolutely drenched.
Yeah, got a lovely spray. I think what I loved about that ride, apart from the awesome theming, was the fact that the top half of you gets wet and the bottom half doesn't.
Well, which is... well, what do you say about?
Oh, do you get wet on the bottom?
Yes.
Oh. Alright, okay, fair enough. Well, just my top and a little bit of my thighs got wet. I've got dry feet, which are always a big bonus. But yeah, nicely sprayed all over the face, all over the t-shirt. Nice and cooled off. Are you enjoying, Kaylee?
Yeah, it was good, yeah. Oh, that backwards drop, I really wasn't expecting that.
Yeah, so the backwards, really unusual, the backwards drop is a double dip. So you actually get air time, yeah, on the backwards drop?
I never even realised that. I never looked anything up about it on purpose, but yeah. I didn't realise it was a double dip. I've never seen a double dip backwards drop.
No, I've never been on like a water ride with a double dip on a backwards drop. That was completely unique, so yeah. That was fantastic. Really, really good. We were on the back as well, yeah. So it's like being on the front on the backwards drop, so that was great. A nice little spray on that backwards drop, nothing too severe. A bit more of a soaker on the final drop.
Yeah.
But to be honest, I think that's just the right amount of wetness. I'm happy with that.
Well, in this temperature, yeah. Not much freezing.
Maybe not on a cold day, but you know, how many cold days live in Spain, I guess. But Rio Bravo, top water ride. I would have liked to have seen some more water effects through there. There was quite a large section after the first backwards drop. where you sort of go through like a town
like
or something.
Like a western town.
Yeah, like a western town. And it was nice, it looked really cool, but nothing happened. And it's like some animatronics or some water effects might have been nice. But Rio Bravo, good solid water ride. Thoroughly enjoyed it.
Yeah.
So we've just exited by the Rio Bravo Outfitters. Back opposite the saloon we were in earlier. So we just left the old West territory and we made our way into the cartoon village. So in the middle of the Toon Land, we've got the Looney Tune fountain. Sadly, it's not switched on today. I mean, it is a shame, it's warm enough. But looks to me like Bugs would normally be rotating around and those two watering cans would probably be getting us pretty pretty wet, but unfortunately no such luck today. Still, it's a really cool piece to look at, even if it's not operating today. Maybe tomorrow, with it being Saturday, they might have it on. So here we have the Looney Tunes shop. There's a bit of comedy on the side here. They've got the Acme Expert Sign Company. You know, they sized that up just right, look. So we've made it over to the Acme Rapids. Loving the cartoon themed props and buildings here. Look at that water tower. That's awesome. So under here. Here we are at the Acme Rapids. More awesome steaming. Just around the back of a little water area. Again, shot is not turned on today. Would have been great for people to cool off. Yeah, here we go, entering the Acme factory. The Acme tour starts here. Pretty cool monorail conveyor belt here. All the different Acme items on, magnets, rockets, boxes, the famous anvil. Got the fans on in here, which is nice, help keeping us cool. So we've made it over to Acme shipping and receiving. It looks like they might have a Tasmanian devil problem. Oh, look at that hole. Yeah, it's all okay there. Looks like him as well. As we continue round, see the signs that he's been, the Taz has been down here. We'll continue our tour of the Acme factory and make our way into the actual station for the boats when they launch. Here's a little off-ride look at the rapids. You can see a boat in the distance. Oh my goodness, it's got spam through the sprayer. That is amazing. The speed at which these rapids go. It looks like an awesome ride. There they go. Get a good spin on there. Looks like one where you need to hang on tight and you get absolutely soaked. Give it a ride. Whee! Just go through the spray. Making sure everyone's got soaked.
Well, we just got drowned in again on the Acme Rapids this time.
Yeah, Acme Rapids, absolutely fantastic. Really, really enjoyed it. The theme is brilliant. Love that when you go into the first, go into the factory and you see all the like the conveyor belt going round. I say a conveyor belt, it's like more like a monorail type system. But yeah, you see all the different Acme items, rockets and things going around. And yeah, absolutely brilliant bit of theming. They had the fans on in there, so it was nice and breezy. So it wasn't too bad waiting in there either. About 25 minutes did we wait in the end?
Yeah, and the timer said 20 minutes, so that was
fine. Yeah, that's pretty close, you know, that's good, much better. And yeah, as I say, it wasn't too bad queuing in there because it was nice and breezy and so on. And the ride itself, absolutely brilliant. I love the theming through the ride. It's really fast, lots of spin, loads of water effects.
Yeah, no, just what you want from the rapids.
Yeah, really, really rapid.
The only thing you missed really was a wave pool.
Yeah, it would have been nice if there was a section where you get sort of, I wouldn't say stuck, but you get sort of slowed down a bit and you spend a bit of time in a wave pool, getting backpackers and forwards. That could have extended the ride time a little bit more on this one. And that might have been nice. But yeah, I mean, really one of the best rapids we've done, I'd say. Definitely in the top five, anyway.
Yeah, it's really good.
So yeah, it's got a complete package. Theming, it's rapid, lots of water effects, so you're bound to get good soaking, which is great in Spain where it's nice and sunny. And yeah, through and through, a really enjoyable rapids ride.
Good old Acme instant tornado, just add water. There's the water tower. Got a little Flintstones truck ride here for the kids as well. So we made it over to Tom and Jerry's picnic in the park. Little family coaster, so I'm gonna go through and give this one a go now. The Looney Tunes, Carrario, Aereo. I think they just tested it. There doesn't seem to be anybody on there at the moment. It just looked very cool, but it's not like a very thrilling ride. I got the Looney Tunes merry-go-round. All the favourite characters. Bugs Bunny, Roadrunner, Wile E. Coyote on his rocket. I'm liking this area with these various statues. Got those over there. And on the right hand side we've got Sylvester and Tweety. So they're ready to play a game of golf, look. Very nice. Ah, we've also located the entrance to La Adventura de Scooby Doo. Now we're gonna try and catch this show, the police stunt show. But we may come back to this shortly. Ah, Taz with an ice cream. Nice. Nam nam nam.
Thank you.
So we've made it over to Stunt 4, the yellow and blue behemoth, a suspended boomerang. I think the only one of these we've done before is perhaps Diabolik in Movie Park in Italy, so should be interesting. So on each row, it alternates between seats close together and seats sort of quite far apart. I think it's so that people get a slightly bit of view, which is pretty cool. But
which is very unique. I haven't seen anything like.
No, I haven't. I don't know. I remember anyway. There it goes again. Yeah, it was an absolutely fantastic ride. It was really, really intense.
Yeah.
Love the sort of slow climb up the hill and then the vertical drop, and then obviously into the roll and into the loop the loop. Really, really good. The seats were a bit close together, perhaps. I mean, there was like a panelling in front of us that was quite close.
Yeah.
That made it feel a little bit claustrophobic, maybe. But yeah, it was super intense, some really good G-force in there. Just knock your head about a little bit, but the restraints were really soft, actually. Yeah.
To be fair, because I'm short, the restraint was like here on my head, so I didn't really hit my head off it anyway because my head was too short. And the restraints
you totally missed it, did you?
Yeah.
Yeah, well, I did get a bit of a few knocks on my head, but nothing serious in the sense that even when I did knock it, it was nice and soft and padded, which is a nice change. So yeah, actually, it's a decent ride.
It was super scary going up there, and you just like kind of pushed into the restraint. It takes you up slowly, and you pushed into the restraint at the front. And obviously, because we was in the middle seats, there was like the metal bit at the front. Like your fingers started touching that, and I was like, no, I'm putting my feet back.
Yeah.
That was a bit scary, really.
Yeah, it was good. Yeah, I mean, it was different. I mean, as I say, these are quite uncommon rides. We haven't been on one for a long time. I think the last time was possibly Movie Park in Italy.
Yeah.
Diabolik is similar. I don't know if it's exactly the same. But really, really enjoyed it because it was so different, really. So we did a flawless coaster recently at Tivoli, and we've done loads of inverted coasters, loads, with obviously Nemesis being in the UK up until recently. So this was a welcome change, something fresh.
Inverted boomerangs are very rare, so it's nice to get on one.
Yeah, really enjoyed it.
Get on one that's so unique, so.
That's it, really enjoyed it. And love the blue and yellow paint job.
Yeah.
Very Looney Tunes.
Yeah, I love that, yeah. It's really good.
Here we are on Cine Tour. Yeah. Oh, there's a cat. It's a real cat as well. He's got partless in his door. Like the garage there in the old car.
He's getting some shade.
Yeah. Map of movie star homes, home of the yellow dodgers, Route 66. Oh, here we go.
Oh no, not
mudslides. Oh no, not mudslides. There's a bit of traffic ahead, look, on the other side of the road. Oh yeah, there's all the Hollywood Boulevard look. It's quite convincing on camera actually. No. Yeah, woods, yeah, okay.
Is it my woods?
Oh, so this is some sound effects, that's quite good. Sounds like we're in the woods now. Quite clever.
I like the bouncy.
Oh, we made it to Santa Monica.
It's a good little car, this.
It's a little
festival.
I know, yeah. Nice little seaside resort there.
Have you got
to
drive the car?
Yeah, it's a fake steering wheel. I do like the rides where a bit like Formula One or whatever it's called at Flamingo Land, where you are on a track but you've got a bit of control over it, which is nice, I think. But you know, it's still a cool ride. I really like the old theme cars, and
yeah,
you know, it's just a nice cruise in the sun, actually, isn't it?
Yeah, that's nice. Nice time to rest your feet and just look at things at the same time.
That's it. It's not a bad lens ride either, actually.
Yeah, we
didn't see
it,
did we? We've only got 5 minutes. Yeah, not even that, really, probably. A few minutes we had to wait, yeah. Oh yeah, coming on back past Hollywood Boulevard.
Traffic,
yeah, unfortunately, one thing about LA, a lot of traffic. So unfortunately, we're about to come to a into a standstill traffic jam. There they are, look. Whoa!
Hey.
Sharp braking there, Kaylee, be careful.
Yeah, I'm not used to braking.
Pedal to
the
bell,
you know.
That's it. Alright, well, slowly but surely cruise our way back into the station. Hollywood Star shop. Plenty of merch, got some Wonder Woman merch here. Some Batman Crocs and sandals. A mixture of goodies there, Batman, Superman. We got the main Batman stuff here. Different hoodies, t-shirts, bottles, even Batman shoes. Actually pretty cool actually. Lots and lots of choice for t-shirts, some joggers, and small hoodie tops. We've even got Batman plushies. Lunch bags and backpacks. Even more t-shirts and joggers. And of course, more plushies. Different kind of plushie. A more sort of cartoony one.
Bear.
And Super Bear. I got some Joker goods, including a Joker apron.
Looks pretty cool.
$9.95, pretty decent. Some more merch over here, Batman versus the Joker type merch, and Joker merch. Lots and lots of t-shirt choices. Mugs. Clock. Some more Batman merch and a bit of Catwoman merch as well. That's a nice one, yeah. It's a little bit more subtle, isn't it? Tank top as well, look. Red t-shirt. To the Batman. Another backpack up there as well.
You just spent a fortune, didn't you?
Yeah, there's a lot of nice stuff if you're into Batman, Superman, and the sort of all the Warner Bros. DC characters. Ah, some Joker plushies at the end.
Oh, the capes are good as well. For the kids as well.
Yeah.
And for adults.
Superhero capes, or adults if you fancy dressing up, yeah. Some more round pillows at the top there as well. Lots and lots of stuff to see merch-wise in here. Lots of exclusive stuff as well. So we're heading into Scooby Doo now. One with quite a lot of a herd. Love the creepy exterior of the building there. Yeah, that's looking really cool. We approach the Haunted Mansion. Little cartoon theme inside. Hey, Scooby Doo! It's a little bit dark in here. The Scooby Doo station. See the gang in the background? So we're just taking our first ride on the Scooby-Doo mystery tour,
yeah.
As it were.
Love Scooby-Doo.
Yeah, I think it's a really nice theme ride. I mean, the outside aesthetic of the sort of mansion's really cool, the creepy mansion. The queue line's quite nice as well. Maybe not quite up to the standard of some of the others, but pretty good through there. Really like the station. There's a big fluorescent area with a gang on there.
Yeah,
the whole...
your mini mystery machine.
Yeah, the cars were like the mini mystery machines. That was really nicely themed, trackless vehicles. Yeah, and the whole thing going through there, the style of it was really nice. I really like the whole ultraviolet theming of it.
Yeah.
It was all fluorescent basically under UV light, which was really different, so I really liked that. It's a shooting game, so you have like a hairdryer shaped
blaster
gun, and it's a fine point blaster, so a little red dot, and we didn't find it to be very accurate, did we?
No, my gun just wasn't working at all, so that was a bit disappointing.
Yeah, and that let Kelly's experience down, especially because one of the really cool things about this ride is that when you do hit a target, it causes something to happen. So like you can, like I hit a box of Scooby snacks and Scooby came up from behind the table, and I shot a painting and it turned into a ghost, and you know, there was quite a lot of interactive elements in there, which were really nice, and it's you know, a really good idea and well put together. The problem is the guns and the targets aren't accurate enough. The other thing that's bizarre is there's lights on the targets, and normally you would aim for the lights, but if you look when you get close, the target where, you know, the target essentially is
in the middle of the, where the light's here and the target's
here. It's like on the bottom corner of the target, not in the middle. Yeah. So you aim for the light, you're probably going to miss, especially from a distance.
So,
I don't know. That's a shame, really, because otherwise it's a really good dark ride. But yeah, love Scooby Doo. Enjoyed the theming in there and so on. But as a shooting game, needs some work, I think.
Yeah.
Heading back through Toontown, the Toon Cartoon Village, and we made it over to the entrance to Bip Bip. We're our first ride on this coaster. Looks like a good ride as well. Got Wile E. Coyote on the front. See him there in the distance. There he goes. Scooby Doo's Tea Party Mystery. Interesting twist on the classic teacups. I love the design, the bright colours and the designs of these cups are great. Got all the gang on them. Really, really cool to look at. It's like all the gang are falling. So we decided to give Foster's Hollywood a try. One of the more upmarket places to eat here, Parque Warner. Got sort of an American sports bar kind of feel to it. There's also an outside terrace, but we thought we'd take a break from the sun. TV's playing the Looney Tunes. Over opposite Stunt 4, you've got the Yogi Bear splash battle. I love all the colourful characters and the boats here. I'm about to get soaked by the look of it. I don't think it quite reaches me, luckily. I didn't quite manage to get there. So we made it over to the Lex Luthor Invertatron. Wonder Woman walking down the street as well. We're going to pop inside LexCorp and have ourselves a ride on the Invertatron. More great theming inside LexCorp. Like all the posters and machinery. Ocean radiation area. A good viewing window here where you can see behind the scenes into the Invertatron as well. There goes the Lex Luthor Invertatron. To Mr. Freeze. It's a traditional swing ride with a nice bit of theme in there. It's all frosted over there and sort of various machinery. Let's get on and give this one a ride. Here we go, we made it over to La Venganza del Enigma. Got the Riddler's Towers. There's three towers in total. Up they go. Ha ha! There goes Gotham City Escape. Made our way over to the entrance to Coaster Express. See it coming round now, look. There it goes. Nice set piece here in the middle of the queue line. On one of the mine cars with an ejector seat. In the Coaster Express queue. Last bit of Western theming in here.
I just took a choo-choo train ride on the Coaster Express.
Yeah, woody coat, the wooden coaster here. And just a little bit disappointed with it, really. Queue line not as well themed as the other rides. Stood out to me straight away. There's a large indoor cattle pen section. There's no fans, there's no air conditioning, so we're all sweating to death
sweating
in there.
Sweating bad, yeah.
You know, for a good half an hour.
And the queue time said 10 minutes, but...
Yeah, and we were there for about 35, something like that.
Yes,
so again, I would just take the app queue times with a pinch of salt, I'm afraid, because they just don't seem to be keeping them up to date properly, so... As a ride, when we first saw the trains coming, we got quite excited because they looked just like the trains at Boulder, which we thoroughly enjoyed at Liseberg. But this coaster could not be more different, to be honest. Firstly...
It started off okay,
yeah.
And we went down the first one, and it wasn't too bad. And then after that, it was just jittering all the time, wasn't it?
Like a real train.
I mean, the good thing is, there wasn't anything to whack your arms or your legs off or anything, so that was good. It was just physically, like, moving you about, but...
Yeah, shaking you around, it's like, you know, gives you a bit of a headache. And, anyway, so for the actual layout, again, not that impressed really. There were some nice big bank turns, and I did quite enjoy those. But there were, like, zero airtime moments.
Yeah.
You know, Boulder's absolutely full of airtime.
It had one tiny little bit of airtime, a little bit...
I didn't notice any, if I'm honest. Too distracted by the shaking.
Also, as well, like I said, you can really notice where the new track had been laid because it was so smooth on the new track bits, and then once you got to the old track, it was just back to juddering. I mean, really, I feel like they should have just done the whole
new
track of the ride, to be honest.
I completely agree. It was closed for quite a long time, so we're here. It was standing and operating for quite a while, and they really should have just done a proper job of it, really. It's a good ride. I mean, you know, everyone. It's to have a go on a Woody, it's great, but it's
great if you love a
feel like a rough Woody.
Feel like a rough Woody. Getting bruised to death, then you.
Yeah, so I guess in that sense it's good. But yeah, I mean, you know, I feel like some of the rides we go on are quite intense, and they don't give you, you know, they don't shake your head up like that. So yeah, mixed feelings on it really. I guess I was a little bit let down versus what I was expecting.
Yeah.
But it's a decent Woody. Don't get me wrong, but. I think the lack of airtime elements really lets it down. I think Boulder really showed us, what a Woody could be in terms of airtime moments. And that was just, an incredible ride. That was completely retracked. It was smooth, yet completely thrilling, super fast, jumping out the seats. But yeah, Coaster Express just didn't really live up to that, did it?
It
unfortunately.
Didn't.
So, yeah, not a bad ride, but certainly not our favourite Woody.
And there was only one train on as well, which made the wait on probably longer, because I think it probably would have been about 10 minutes if there was two trains on, but there was only one train on, so maybe that was why the queue time said 10 minutes.
Yeah, that's perhaps right. And again, this is Saturday now, this is day two, so on a Saturday, and there are some rides now running two trains, that were running one yesterday, which is good to see. But yeah, sadly, Coaster Express not one of them, so again, unnecessary wait in the sort of hot cattle pens, unfortunately. So
we're now leaving the old West Territory as we make our way back into the Cartoon Village. Something really important to note, especially when it's nice and hot like today, is the slushy station right over here. Just as you come out of the old West, get your hands on some beautiful slushies. They've got a fine collection of tops as well to put on your slushy cup. We've got Batman, Tweety Pie, Bugs Bunny, and Taz as well. Cartoon Network shop over on the left. Fountain in the middle, sadly still not running today. Disappointing given the heat. Got the Cartoon Cafe on the right hand side. They serve pasta buffet and also some paella. So we've got our slushies. We managed to get a Batman and Taz one yesterday, so we thought we'd get a couple of Bugs Bunnies today. Both love Bugs Bunny. So I've got strawberry and raspberry, I think it is, and Katie's got cola and strawberry. They're €7 each, and that includes the cup. Other shop opposite, they've got some pretty cool stuff. That's Tweety Pies Velma, cool Scooby Doo tank tops, Scooby Doo crossover with the Looney Tunes.
Yeah, I like this one. I think I'm
gonna
get myself one of these.
Yeah, they're very nice. Scooby Doo to the rescue. Some more plushies. Taz plushies. Some Harry Potter crossovers with the Looney Tunes.
I love these.
Well, what a busy couple of days we've had here at Parque Warner Madrid.
Yeah, it's been quite a lot of walking around, hasn't it?
Yeah, it has. It's quite a large park and it's been very hot.
Yeah.
Say sort of highs of 28, 29 degrees, so I say very hot. I mean, I know it could be hotter, but bearing in mind a week ago we were in Denmark and it was 8 degrees, so pretty hot compared to that.
Yeah.
But yeah, it's been a nice park. I liked all the Looney Tunes theming. I really liked all the show buildings and that sort of thing. I think they're just incredibly done. You know, there's lots to see around the park. You know, it's really, 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 really good for that.
Yeah, the sun show was good as well. Enjoy the sun show.
Yeah, that's right. We caught the police academy stunt show yesterday. It was pretty good. It was maybe, it was about 50-50 between dialogue and stunts, I would say. So it's something you can still enjoy in if you don't understand Spanish. We certainly still enjoyed it.
Yeah.
They had all sorts of different vehicles in there. Lorries, monster truck, cars, bikes, all sorts of things. So yeah, really, you know, quite comical as well. So we really enjoyed that. I think really the rides here are pretty good. I mean, I think we're really glad that we did spend 2 days here at this park. Something to be aware of, when you purchase a ticket at the moment, I don't know if this offer will carry on indefinitely, but currently if you purchase a ticket, you can come back the next consecutive day for only €6.
Yep.
Now given we paid the Friday price for coming on Friday, then got to come Saturday for €6, that sounds a really good deal.
Yeah, and also if you're not sure if you want to spend 2 days here, you can buy your 1 day ticket and buy the €6 ticket the same day when you're here in the park.
Yeah, you can get it from the box office. You don't have to get it online. If you know you want to come for 2 days, then you can get it online. If you if you're unsure, you can always get it at the box office and upgrade afterwards, and they'll give you an issue with a second day ticket. But yeah, I think the only real letdown for this park's really been sort of operations, really. Not just the staff, but also just the decision to only run one train. I mean, we did Coaster Express for the first time today, a second day too, but only one train running on it. And again, we were left waiting in the sweltering heat.
It could be that they've got maintenance issues and maybe they've only got one train that's working or something.
Yeah, perhaps there's a legitimate reason for it, but it's just disappointing on a Saturday when it's really busy. And obviously, you know, you want to get as many rides in as you can. And it's actually felt like we've needed these 2 days to get everything done without it being manic. And to be honest, even if we had a rush around like manic, which we did a little bit at Europa Park, I still don't feel like we would have got everything done. Not if we'd have just come yesterday. The park closed 8 o'clock yesterday. It was 12 till 8. And today the hours are 12 till 10 p.m. So we are leaving a tad early just so we can have a bit of a break before we get to park the attractions tomorrow. But yeah, I think that's really the only thing. The operations haven't really been up to par with the other parks, really. Yeah, it's been quite crowded as well, and that's sort of contributed to the atmosphere being a bit off. But that's not the park's fault, obviously. But I do feel like the that could have been alleviated a little bit if the operations had been a bit better. If they were, it's a bit harder to get the trains out a bit faster. Make sure they're running as many trains as they possibly can, really, you know. Today they did have two trains on a couple of the rides, didn't they?
Yeah.
Which they didn't yesterday, which was good. But still, you know, a lot of room for improvement there. So hopefully they'll take the initiative and sort of get on top of that. But yeah, otherwise it's been a really pleasant day, hasn't it?
Yeah. I just love walking around and seeing all the females. That's what I love.
Yeah, the Looney Tunes are funny, and I really like that the queue lines, even where they're cattle pens, most of the time they've been really well themed. You know, like the Acme Rapids, for example, that's a cattle pen queue line, but you look around in the ceiling, there's loads to look at. It's really amusing. It's really nicely put together. And yeah, that was one of the best. That was probably the highlight for me, actually, the Acme Rapids, and that was probably one of the best rapids we've been on, hasn't it?
It was. It was fantastic.
It's beautifully themed, and you know, just really all comes together, doesn't it? Really. So thoroughly enjoyed that. So yeah, say it's a pretty good park. We enjoyed Park Warner Madrid.
Yeah.
Yeah. So we hope you liked this video. If you do, please like and subscribe. It really helps us out and the channel out, and it means a lot to us. If you have any comments or questions about Park Warner, then please just drop those in the comments below, and we'll do our best to answer those as soon as possible.
Yeah. Till next time then.
Till next time. Yeah. We hope you get out and explore amusement parks and more. See you next time.